this is Crazy Horse Mountain. They're gonna carve a whole mountain out into, there's the horse's head. That's his arm. And this is what it's gonna look like when it gets through. I heard you.
We need it. Your binoculars.
Sure, Mom.
Hi, Dad.
Hi, Jim. Hi, Mom. Hi, Tim. Tim's up there trying to get weights in the rocks if he can get out. that about right? Have you looking over?
I'm not standing over there.
So I can get a picture of you standing looking over. Lean on the rail. It
you know how close I get, and this is close.
The rail won't let you fall, see? Okay, then take a picture of me leaning on the rail, then. It's still going.
Smart Alex, stop it. You know that.
Where's the red button?
It takes a little bit of patience. You have to be still, though. They're wild animals.
And there's one out there in this little room.
Where'd you go to that?
Tim, right there on the... They're everywhere.
The blue one. This is taken from the porch of the, where we stopped to have lunch. I'm just laying back after having a big dinner of buffalo stew.
Thank you.
laying back there, just enjoying it. Tim, he's got his feet up, boy, he's really with the program. Tripping, there's some bunch of buffalo out here. They're everywhere out here. They're over here, they're
watch yourselves. I'm gonna pull
down
right
in there. And there's a lot of them back in here. Just everywhere. One nursing. Kind of see a nursing there. As you can tell, we're really close to them. Everywhere. No baby ones. There's the bull. That's a big bull. There he is right there. There's another bull. He's snarling at you. He's huge. He just walked right in front of us here. Right across the path. He's kind of big, mean looking. Makes you want to go pet him, huh?
Looks like they had a good spring on calves.
Yeah, just stole his wife and took off about 95-98%.
Scratching the dirt over there.
Look at him all up here, staying
grassed. He's big.
Yep. Huge.
You know, there's trees here, like the one on the right. Buffalo rub the bark off of these trees.
Yep.
Sometimes they go all the way around.
There he is.
It's unbelievable how big their shoulders are and how look.
Pigtail bridge. Get over the bridge down or circle just to get down lower.
Bigger to take up all that space, because then it would look disproportioned a little bit. A lot of people wonder why Theodore Roosevelt was on the mountain. Actually, nowadays, nobody really doesn't like it, or a lot of people feel that that's just a fine choice, but of that time, it was very controversial. A lot of people thought, well, why is Theodore Roosevelt up there? What did he do? Obviously, they knew what he did, but he wasn't in the history books enough. And a lot of people thought he wasn't worthy of this kind of tribute right now. But Guthrie Borglum explained to these men and these women at that time that he was so full of energy and he was so robust that he wanted a 20th century present up there. And he thought Theodore Roosevelt best represented what was going on in that time today. That was going on in history and of the 20s and the energy that everyone had and the spirit that everyone had. And that's why he chose Theodore Roosevelt. Not because of the reason that he worked so well with the parks and he was a conservationist. A lot of people think that that's what it had to do with. But that's not actually true. It was just for his energy and his spirit. So basically that was another change that went on. Some other changes are, in March of 1940,
sort of follow that road up. Road goes way down. Beautiful valley.
See, way down in the end. Down, you see, we way down there. We climbed the whole top of the hill.
We climbed all day.
The front seat before I do. Oh, yes. No, sometimes we put him in the back, but he doesn't like it much.
He's terrified.
It's the Shell Falls. I guess it's just like a little waterfall. Can't breathe. Here's the bottom of the Shell Falls. White water. Rocks are over a million years old.
Here's a scenery view. Mountains.
People in the dormant stage. We're sitting out here waiting for her to erupt.
It looks like it's starting.
You're getting a lot steamier, huh?
Yes, it is.
They used to have, last time I was here, they had a sign that it would erupt approximately this time because I was raised
up on the island. Oh, what's your point?
Well, because you didn't think that I knew that. And we live right by Yellowstone Lake. Yeah. Well, I was telling my son, I think it's a natural lake going up to the because I was noticing on the map that they gave us that it said, and it has a kind of a dotted line all around it. It's called the
Tim says it's all over with.
Stand right here.
Yeah, you bet.
Oh, it's 2 minutes over there. Exactly.
Please, Mom, say that wasn't it.
I don't want better than that.
Are we there yet, Mama?
Are we having fun yet?
Oh, please, give me a break.
Old Faithful, not very faithful anymore.
There it is. There it is. See? There, Tim. Get it. Oh. Let's clap. Yay! We could
help. Tim, it's erupting right now.
We got two of them.
Yeah.
Nobody claps or nothing. Or
let's beat him up.
Hooray! Okay. Hooray! Hip hip hooray! Golly!
That's taller. It's about the same height as the one.
Virginia says it's pretty
wide. It looks the same. It looks a lot more natural. All
you know,
steam
I think
stuff.
That if you were on the other side like that, you'd sure get a lot better picture.
You can't either tell whether it's water or steam.
Looks like it takes steam from around the other hot spots. Hot steam.
Well, that's all she wrote, folks. Get back in another hour and a half.
There's a Mount, I'm not sure.
Peaks.
Yeah. There's all the Teton Peaks. There's Mount Moran. Up. There's a man. there's a scenic view of what we're doing, or what we're doing, or where we're traveling. And we're about to be in Jackson, Wyoming. Here's the road. Bridge. There they are again.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Dad. Did you have fun fishing?
Oh, yeah.
This is Megan, my helper.
Hi, Megan.
Hi. Who's what? Oh, Daddy, yeah. Oh, here it is. Lots of money floating around here, Dad, with all these...